Professional DAWs can come at a big investment in not only money, but time to learn and master as well. Whether you're looking for another DAW to tackle, or even if you're brand new to audio production, these free DAWs are definitely worth looking into. Hey everyone, Transverse Audio here. You can find the download link to any of these DAWs in the description below. With that being said, let's get to it. This list has most of the popular DAWs available that are free. We have even more free DAWs coming up right after this list. The ideal use of each DAW that we've listed is simply a suggestion based on what they really excel at. There's a few DAWs on this list that I'd like to point out before we move on. Lmms Studio has an amazing feature that's really rare for a DAW to have. With Lmms Studio, you can collaborate real time with anyone, anywhere. And what I mean by this is that you can work on the same project at the exact same time with more than one person from anywhere in the world. You can chat in the DAW and see what they're doing as well. And if you just can't sit still when producing your music, or like to work on the go, Soundtrap works on any device, your phone, tablet, laptop, or computer, you name it. When it comes to traction though, it's a bit complex as to how to upgrade to the paid version. Now there's nothing wrong with the DAW itself, but be cautious if you're trying to upgrade. The paid version of Traction comes free with the purchase of certain products from Behringer and Mackie, so don't go buying the cheapest thing to get the DAW. Make sure it comes with it first. Now these two have been brought out into their own section, and for a good reason. Audacity and Bosca Seol are tools you should definitely check out, especially useful for those niche projects, even if you have a dedicated DAW already. Let's start off with Audacity. This DAW is a go-to for anyone involved with podcasts or voice acting. It comes with plenty of effects built in. A lot of them are useful for many projects, from getting your levels right to making your voice sound like a robot, monster, or like you're talking through a radio, and much more. This is a great choice for this niche, as it handles audio editing in a very precise way. You won't get distracted by all the tools and abilities regular DAWs would have, so you can focus on the task at hand. Being open source, this has a lot of potential for updates in the future. Now, Bosca Seol is a bit different. It's essentially a DAW dedicated to chiptune or low-bit styles of music, and it's got some pack to its punch. It all comes as is, so you won't be able to use any third-party plugins or effects directly in the DAW, but it's not like you'll need any. With its simplicity, this is a great tool for audio producers of any skill level, and even game developers who just want to do their own music. To start using it, you can either download the software or even spin it up on your browser. Now let's go over some DAWs that really deserve a shout-out. The three DAWs here have some pretty compelling features, each worth talking about in more detail. If you're literate with sheet music or want to learn more about it and have access to a Linux computer, Rose Garden is definitely worth experimenting with. It comes with a notation editor, so you can actually write a song using sheet music or simply use the piano roll, which is the MIDI editor. Now, if chiptune or bit music is your thing and you want to also use your own plugins or simply want to be inside of a more standard DAW environment, Lmms has got you covered. It comes with quite a few plugins that emulate those nostalgic video game sounds. Better yet, it's compatible with Windows, Mac, and Linux. Lumit is a DAW that recently went through some pretty impressive changes. It's now known as Soundbridge, but you can still find it under Lumit. Its new interface alone will make you want to try it, but its capability and workflow will make you want to stay. Out of the DAWs in this video, these are probably the best choices depending on your operating system or platform. Although this is just in our opinion, it all comes down to what works for you. For Windows, Soundbridge has the upper hand. It's basically a full version DAW packed with pretty much all the features you need. You can quickly load in your own plugins, find your way around the DAW, and learn from an abundance of resources on their blog. Soundbridge's layout is really user-friendly, so you'll be able to master it in no time. The best for Mac goes to GarageBand. Sharing a near-identical user interface with Apple's flagship DAW, Logic, you have a seamless upgrade path to one of the leading DAWs in the industry. Not to mention, there is also a GarageBand app for iOS, so you can make your music wherever you are. Its simplicity and arsenal of sounds will have you ready to produce even at entry level. There's an abundance of resources to learn from, all interactive and all integrated into the DAW. With it being exclusive for Linux, Qtractor takes the lead. It comes with many unlimited features and it is also open source. It was specifically made for Linux, but having it optimized for it comes at a small cost. There may not be as big of a community as DAWs made for more popular operating systems. If you'd rather make your music online or on the go, Audio Tool is the perfect DAW. With everything being cloud-based, you can collaborate and access your projects much easier, so you can go from your computer to your phone, then to your friend's computer. Now, after you've made your music, you can actually publish it through Audio Tool's built-in publishing platform. That's it for the list, everyone. Let us know in the comments below what your favorite DAW is. Oh, and if we didn't mention it, tell us about it too. Don't forget to subscribe, and as always, thanks for watching.